evening, everyone, and welcome to the February 13th, 2017 board meeting. At this time, I will direct the Pledge of Allegiance to my superintendent, Raven Newberry.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
This is one of the times in the board meeting when community members are allowed to address the board. There will also be a public hearing at the end of the meeting. Does anyone in the audience wish to be heard at this time?
Madam President, I'm a parent of a Roseville student. I've been seeing a lot of marketing and signage about the Success Program. My child also told me of some incentives her school is offering for good attendance. Can you tell me about the Success Program and why the initiative was created?
That's a very good question. Ms. Raven Newberry, our superintendent of schools, will be happy to outline and preside over that issue.
Thank you so much for bringing up this subject. I would like to direct this to our deputy superintendent, Madison Kurtz, to give more details about the Success Program. If any board members have any questions or comments, please feel free to ask.
Success was created to address the number of absences students and staff have throughout the year. Our hope is to draw attention to this important issue and work on improving the attendance of our students and staff.
Ms. Skukani?
It sounds like a great way to bring awareness to absenteeism. What's the reason the district decided to create this initiative?
Chronic absenteeism, or missing at least 10% of school days in a school year for any reason, excused or unexcused, is a primary cause of low academic achievement and a powerful predictor of those students who may eventually drop out of school. An estimated 5 to 7.5 million students miss 18 or more days of school each.
Mr. Rinke?
Has the initiative been successful?
We have some positive reports from schools that incentives are helping bring awareness and improve attendance, but we will run data at the end of the school year to assess the impact of the initiative. We hope data will show a decreased number of absences from our students and staff.
Excuse me, Madam President, can I ask a question?
Mr. Smith.
I'm glad our district is addressing this with our students, but what impact does staff attendance have on the district?
Ms. Newberry, can you provide us with some information about the impact?
When we have teachers and support staff absent from school, there can be financial implications as well as difficulties in running the district efficiently and effectively. Mr. Atkinson, our Assistant Superintendent of Human Resources, can provide some specific information about the staff absenteeism.
Anytime we have a staff absent, it's necessary to fill that spot with a substitute. On a day-to-day basis, the inability to secure substitutes for absent classroom teachers has created a burden for principals who are required to reorganize building staff in order to provide coverage.
Ms. Lovejolly?
So what do the schools do if there are not enough subs to cover the building for a day?
Our teachers have been understanding of this issue, and many times they will give up their prep period to cover one of the classes. Unfortunately, this can be difficult on teachers who no longer are able to use that time to prepare lesson plans or grade papers.
What are the qualifications for a substitute? Do they have to be a certified teacher or highly qualified?
We prefer them to be, but the minimum state requirement is 60 college credit hours. However, when you have a substitute, they don't know the children, their learning needs, or the curriculum as well as the regular teacher. Despite their best efforts, it's often a diminished day compared to having the regular teacher in class. Having our teachers in the classroom is important to our students' academic achievement.
Ms. Longjolly?
I would like to thank Mr. Atkinson for extensive knowledge on staffing.
Thank you.
Ms. Kay.
There seems to be some obvious academic issues when students and staffs are absent from school, but what are the financial implications on the district?
Ms. Newberry, are you aware of the financial impact on this district?
That's a great question. I'd like to direct this to our Executive Director of Finance to offer some information, Ms. Gibson.
Fortunately, the overwhelming majority of staff report on a daily basis, but if we were to have high absenteeism rate by staff, it would cost the district additional funds to compensate substitutes in the classrooms and other support positions in the district. This could negatively impact other budgets in the district in order to make up the costs.
Have we been able to provide our substitute with competitive wages?
This year, we increased the compensation for our substitute teachers. Our wages are very competitive within the county.
Has the increase in sub pay attracted more subs?
The increase has allowed us to be on par with other districts and keep the subs we do have on staff. The inability to secure enough substitutes is not a Roseville problem. This is an issue that all Macomb County schools deal with on a daily basis.
Thank you, Ms. Gibson. Being a substitute teacher is not an easy job. I'm glad our district is doing everything it can to keep the ones that we have. Mr. Rinke?
I recently read the article in the newspaper about the renovation of the weight room at Roseville High School. I know we approved naming the room after Rex Corliss, who is a former teacher and coach in our district. Can you give us an update on the project?
Mr. Dombrowski should be able to answer this question. He is the director of the Buildings and Grounds.
The athletic department has coordinated collaborative effort to raise over $30,000 to fund the renovation. The work began over the summer and continued throughout the fall and winter. All of the work has completed, and earlier this month, the room was officially reopened, with a short ceremony.
Ms. Shkugani?
Can you give some details about how we organized and completed the renovation?
I'll go ahead and pass that question to the Coordinator of Transportation and Maintenance, Ms. LeBlanc.
I'd be happy to report on the project. The athletic department formulated a plan with input from the high school coaches that incorporates some existing equipment and some new functional pieces that will help update the room to better needs of our student athletes. In addition to repairing and purchasing new equipment, the project included some new signage and sound system.
Ms. Shkugani?
Can you tell us where the funding came from for the renovation?
That's a great question. All of the funds for the renovation have been donated. The majority of them came from the Rex Corliss account and his family. Additionally, a number of Roseville High School clubs, groups, and individuals have also contributed to the budget.
Madam President, can I ask another question?
Mr. Schmidt.
All right, so this seems like a great project for our students, but how do the kids utilize the weight room on a daily basis?
The weight room is used every day. It will have a huge impact on a large number of students. The athletic department sponsors 31 high school teams, and the weight room is used on a daily basis by our PE department for the physical fitness classes, progressive and resistance, and aerobics.
Thank you, Mr. Dombrowski and Ms. LeBlanc for following up with these projects. Our students really appreciate the new Rex E. Corliss fitness room.
You're very welcome. We're happy to support the renovation. We have received reports that there has been a significant boost in the activity in the weight room since the renovation. We feel this project has made a big impact on our students.
Ms. Vest?
Ms. Terry Martin, can you elaborate on some of the improvements in technology in our district?
Our Director of Technology, Ms. Kevlar, can you give the details regarding some of the technology projects that have been completed or are still in progress?
We have made some big technology updates to the district lately. Every classroom at the high school is equipped with an Elmo projector and a sound system. Many teachers are using Apple TV to support the use of teacher iPads for interactive instruction. And recently, we purchased Chromebooks for use at the high school.
Ms. Vest?
Have there been any technology updates which have affected the curriculum?
We have supported our new 9th and 10th grade English language arts curriculum with Chromebook carts for all those English classrooms.
So does that mean that our students won't have English textbooks anymore?
No, the ELA collection is an active and engaging curriculum with a blended digital and printed approach.
I know we have some great career technical education classes. Have we been able to support these programs with appropriate technology updates?
Yes, the AutoCAD lab has been updated to support current software versions, and Mr. Trice's computer lab has been updated for our business department and web design classes. All of these stations are equipped with dual monitors to help with student projects.
Ms. Vest?
Ms. Terry Martin, I would like to ask Ms. Cavalier, are other schools in the districts utilizing any new technology? Do our middle schools have the same access to new technology?
They absolutely do. In fact, with support of a grant, we have been able to purchase approximately 1,200 iPads for our middle schools. Additionally, every classroom is equipped with Apple TV, and many teachers at all levels are using Google Apps for Educators, which is a communication and collaboration application that allows students to work from any device and from anywhere on documents and projects.
Thank you, Ms. Kevlar, for the technology updates.
Ms. President, can you offer us an update on our special education programs and services in the district?
Ms. Major is our Director of Special Education. Ms. Major, can you provide us with this information?
I would love to. Thank you, Ms. Terry Martin. We are currently providing services to 865 students in the districts, which is approximately 17% of our population. Students may qualify for services due to speech impairment, learning disabilities, cognitive impairment, emotional impairment, otherwise health impairment, physical impairment, early childhood development delay, hearing impairment, or visual impairment.
What students are receiving special education services? Are these students just middle school or high school students?
Roseville provides special education programs for students from preschool, ages 2.5 to grade 12.
Are other districts providing special education programs for students in preschool and early elementary grades?
Our district has been really leading the way in the Macomb County with services and programs for our youngest children with special needs. We were the first Macomb County district to offer a special education kindergarten class in the fall of 2011. Roseville also runs the only elementary and middle school total communications hearing impaired classrooms in the Macomb County.
We have made a commitment to educate all of our students appropriately. It has been important to support all kids, even our youngest ones, with programs that allow them to reach their full potential.
Ms. Kukani.
I commend the efforts the district is making to support our kids with special needs, but what are we doing to challenge our high achievers?
Ms. Newberry, can you provide us with how our schools are pushing our top students?
I'll direct that question to the Director of Curriculum, Mr. Gonzalez, who can provide us with an update on our curriculum initiatives that are geared towards our advanced students.
Roseville Community Schools has many programs to offer for all students, including the Gifted and Talented program at the elementary level. The program is a pull-out program for students in grades 3 through 5th for those who qualify as gifted or talented using certain criteria. Our middle school offers advanced coursework in math and English and language arts. Students now can earn high school credit in algebra and foreign language, which opens up their schedule to take our wide selection of elective courses when they get to high school.
Madam President, can I ask a question?
Mr. Schmidt.
Thanks. So what about the high school? Are there any programs or opportunities for the high-achieving students?
At the high school, students can earn college credit through dual enrollment or participate in early college programs in numerous AP courses. Next year, the high school offers 6 new AP classes: human geography, psychology, world history, calculus, environmental science, and physics.
That's a ton of AP classes in addition to the ones they're already offering. Roseville High will have enough opportunities for the top performing students.
Mr. Enke?
Ms. Newberry, student hunger is a concern across the nation. Are we addressing this issue here in Roseville?
Our supervisor of food service, Mr. Kovalchuk, can speak on these.
The Healthy Hunger Free Kids Act of 2010 provided provisions for school districts with at least 40% of students directly certified by the state as being entitled for free. Currently, we offer free breakfast and lunch to all students at Dort, Huron Park, Kaiser, Kement, Steelen, Penn, and Roseville Middle School. We also offer free breakfast to all students at Fountain.
Ms. Vest,
is this program only available during the school year?
We also participate in the Seamless Summer Feeding Program. We provide free breakfast and lunch at selected sites to any child 18 years and under. This is to ensure that all children have access to healthy and nutritious food when school's out.
Mr. Enke?
So anybody 18 years or younger will be provided a free lunch or breakfast all summer long at some select schools in Roseville.
Yes, they can. In fact, some of our athletic teams use this program for summer practices so the kids can receive a meal before or after their workout. Also, our summer school academic camps and classes utilize this program as well.
Thank you, Mr. Kovalchuk. It's so nice to hear that so many kids are taking advantage of our food service programs.
Ms. Longjolly?
Ms. Terry Martin, I've been to a lot of sporting events at Roseville High School this year. I have noticed many of our sports teams have new Nike uniforms. Is there a reason all of our new uniforms have been Nike?
Ms. Newberry, can you offer some insight? Our teams are looking good.
I think our board attorney, Ricky Shackelford, can offer some more information about our agreement put together between Nike and Roseville High School. Mr. Shackelford?
The athletic department at the high school has been working to get an agreement with Nike to make our school sponsor. And if do we ever get the deal, the advantages will not only benefit our students and our athletes, but our budget as well.
What exactly does it mean to be a Nike school?
If the board were to approve the Nike Rewards program for the high school, within the next 3 years, all varsity teams will be wearing Nike.
Will the Nike uniforms be more expensive?
No, the incentives and preferred pricing will keep prices competitive with current uniform suppliers. Additionally, over the next 3 years, Nike will provide Roseville High School with Nike coupon money to spend on new Nike products at no cost to the district.
It sounds like a really good opportunity for Roseville High School, but what if you don't like the uniforms and want something different?
That's a pretty good question. If Roseville isn't satisfied, they can simply just terminate the the deal at any time.
This is, will be very exciting for our athletes. I'm sure they will be very happy to get new Nike uniforms. Ms. Gugani.
Ms. Terry Martin, can you provide the board with an update on our marketing and communications department? I've seen a significant increase in the press and social media for our school district.
The marketing and communications department is in charge of bragging about our great district. They distribute information to the community through our website, social media, district newsletters, newspapers, and media ads.
Ms. McSwain is our director of communications and marketing. Ms. McSwain, can you provide some additional details about your department?
Definitely. We certainly take the opportunity to brag about all the great stuff happening around the district as much as possible, but we do much, much more. We are very active on social media, posting happenings around the district throughout our Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube pages. We also handle writing and distributing press releases, as well as creating ads for various media outlets, including newspapers, cable television, magazines, and movie theaters. We handle content for our district cable channel and Roseville Community Schools website, which is designed and updated in-house.
Mr. Inke?
I have seen a lot of articles in the local newspapers. It's nice to see positive things about Roseville schools in the media. What are some things you do for our parents, students, and teachers in the district?
We release a quarterly newsletter bringing together pictures, articles, teacher and alumni profiles, and up-to-date calendars. We mail these to every resident and business in Roseville, as well as post it in our website. We handle photography and filming at many district events, including school concerts, plays, musicals, sporting events, select board meetings like this one, and various other events.
Ms. Kukani?
It sounds like we have made a bigger effort to share information and promote our district. Is there any way teachers, administrators, or even parents can be involved and share their ideas?
Of course. We always welcome new ideas from our parents and staff. We have a marketing committee that meets monthly, and we encourage staff and parents to attend these meetings to help with community presence at local events and share ideas on how to best market our district.
Thank you, Ms. McSwain, for your efforts in the marketing communication department.
If there are no other questions or comments at this time, we'll continue on with the next agenda item. This is the last public hearing of the night. Does anybody wish to be heard? Please sign in and keep your comments to 3 minutes or under.
No way.
No way.
Stop playing.
Board of Education. When that class of 2017 showed up at the high school 4 years ago, I had a full head of blonde curls in my head. Now, this is what they've done to me. But I regress. I've not missed many proms in my life. I've worked some of my best years given to the Roseville Community Schools, give everything I've got. I've only missed a couple proms, and now I'm hearing that you're changing prom from a Saturday night to a weeknight. Can you please explain the madness?
That's a very good question. I'm going to have to turn that over to my superintendent, Raven Newberry.
I mean, what's next? Homecoming on a Friday night?
Officer Gessmiler.
Yes,
I would like to direct this question to the Director of Special Education, Brittany Major.
Please tell me it's in the same spot, right? You didn't move it from St. Clair Shores either, did you?
Yeah, we also moved the location. It's due to, we have to renew our system that we're having here. We got 2017 class over here. So we gotta make the improvements for them. And we just thought that having it on a school night, or, well, not school night for the seniors.
For me, I'm in a knitting club.
I understand there is some conflicts, but we did change it. Due to having attendance, we'll make it much more efficient for the senior class graduating.
Thank you, Ms. Major.
Of course.
Oh my God.
Oh no.
Stop.
Hello, board. I just had a quick question. I'm very concerned in and amongst the students. I've heard some chatter about there being smoke in the bathrooms. So I was just wondering what you were going to do about that.
Well, right now that is a current issue we're actually looking into. The board, in a collaborative effort, we're looking into it. It's still an ongoing process right now, but We are looking into it, and we're very aware of your concerns. We understand it is not good for the students. Nobody should be smoking in the bathrooms.
Well, that's all I can ask for. Thank you.
Okay, the public hearing is now closed, and it is now time for nice things happening with Mr. Blaskowski.
First of all, can we give the students a hand here? Personally, Mr. Gus Weiler, since you're taking that knitting class, I noticed how you were needling all those students. Sorry, I couldn't resist. It's that time of the meeting that we do our nice things happening, things that happen in the district. On this special night, we're going to take some time for our student school board to recognize someone who has made a difference in their lives. Many of these people being recognized tonight interact with our students, your children, and do not realize the impact that they've had on that individual. They go about doing what they do best, teaching, coaching, mentoring. Tonight, we just have a sample of the staff who are being recognized. There are many more out there in our district that are not here tonight, but we thank each and every one of you for your dedication to our students and making a difference. If I could ask all the staff who are being honored tonight to please go up and stand behind the student that is recognizing you. Don't be shy.
I can't believe Matt Martis.
You're on.
Yay. Okay, so I'm going to be honoring my chemistry teacher, Mr. Reinowski.
I put together a nice little essay for you.
Okay. So in my junior year of high school, I walked into Mr. Reinowski's chemistry class thinking about how badly I was going to fail because I was really awful at science. But once I actually sat in his class and watched him teach, I knew there was something much different about him. He taught in a way I actually understood, and I somehow managed to get all A's in his class, even got an A+ on my finals. There's never been another teacher that has clicked with me like that. Not only did he become one of the best teachers I've had, he also became a person I could look to for help, not in just school, but also in life. I remember, I remember for a good 3 months, I bugged him to give me $20 to help me pay for my medical trip. And he was like, I don't know, I'll think about it, but probably not, because then I have to give everyone else money. So then one day I had a conversation with one of my gym teachers about mock school board, and he's like, hey, are you going to take Reinowski? Because I see he's like your new buddy. And I was like, I don't even know what that is. So then I thought about it, and I went and talked to him. And he told me that he had never been picked for this before. So me being me said, hey, if you give me that $20. Oh God. So I told him I'd pick him. So actually, he eventually did give me the $20. But we just laughed about it. Little did he know I was actually going to pick him. But not just because he was giving me $20, but because I could even joke about that with him. And so anyway, that's besides the point. I have learned that Mr. Reinowski and I have the same personality. We truly are one and the same. He could come in having a bad day with a really bad attitude, and well, I'd be having a bad day too. So he'd give me an attitude and he'd get it back. We took it well from each other, which isn't common. Most people get in really big fights about it, but we found it normal, continued our day as if it never happened. We even have the same views on politics. I could gossip with him all day about how the world should be run. But all in all, Mr. Reinowski has and will forever be the best teacher I could have asked for.
And because of him, I finally figured out what truly helps me learn and what my learning style is. On top of that, even though I'm going into the medical field, starting next year in college, I will be majoring in chemistry.
All right, so I'm honoring Mr. King here. You know, Mr. King, there's a lot of words that come to my mind when I think of him. You know, he's a pretty swell teacher. He's a mentor, coach, and a friend. But, you know, it didn't really start like that. It started off, when I first met Mr. King, it was my sophomore year. I walked into chemistry, and I looked at him, and, you know, he just, first appearances, he's just some guy with some corny jokes. Well, it turned out to be a lot more than that. You know, after that, you know, getting to know him, I soon learned that he was going to be my new Quiz Bowl coach. So, you know, I would go to Quiz Bowl practice and stuff, and, you know, that I get to know Mr. King some more. So, eventually he became some guy, you know, I could just go to, talk to, and have a laugh with. But now, you know, as I started going through high school, my problems, I started to get more problems, and I started to talk to him more, and he's giving me a lot of advice, and the advice, I didn't always take his advice and stuff, you know, because he kind of wanted me to stop doing enrollment so I can go play Quiz Bowl, but stuff happens, you know. So now he's not just some guy with his corny jokes. He's a pretty swell guy in my book.
I'm going to appreciate Mr. Moore. I only had Mr. Moore for my junior year, but I don't recall relating to any other teacher more. The amount of times I heard him say I was just like you is uncountable. I loved going to trigonometry. I mean, yes, I enjoy math, but my reasoning goes far beyond that. It was the constant jokes back and forth between me and Mr. Moore. It was the trash talk for dodgeball that went on for a week. It was the stories he would tell about his high school days. It was the teacher relationship that every student wishes they had. One thing I can't thank him enough for is reminding me of my potential. That, you know, you should have an A+, right? Reminder. Anytime I started to slack, he'd be on me, reminding me that I could do so much better. He was the first teacher to ever let me know that. When Roseville claims they help us achieve our full potential, no other teacher could have possibly helped me better. Although he didn't notice it directly in his class, that I could be doing better mentality has stayed with me since, and I don't see it going away. Mr. Moore deserves so much more credit than even I just gave him. He impacted not only my high school, but my life. I regret sleeping in every morning now. I love all my teachers, but I still miss going to his class. I guess what I'm really trying to say is thank you. Thank you, Mr. Moore, for everything you taught me, everything you made me realize, and everything I will accomplish because of you.
I'm honoring my dance coach, Coach K. An influential person in my life, without a doubt, is Coach Kaylee. Having a coach in the physically and mentally art of dance is different than any other sport. Having the all-year season, it is near impossible to not become close with such an amazing person after spending my entire high school career with her. Caring, creative, hardworking, with a bit of tough love, qualities in you I aspire to be. I thank you for trusting and believing in me to be captain for these past 2 years. I thank you for all the sacrifices you have made. It is truly amazing that you can work, coach, and plan your wedding. You are a role model not only in the dance season, but in everyday life. I thank you for pushing me, knowing I can do better even when I thought less of my ability. I don't know what I would do without your influences, and I appreciate everything you have done for me throughout these years. Because of you, I have a level of confidence and grace I wouldn't have otherwise. And lastly, I thank you for being... I thank you for being the big sister I've never had.
Tonight I have the privilege to honor Mr. Randolph, but unfortunately he couldn't be here tonight. Mr. Randolph has made a difference in my life by showing me how he cares for each individual student, even the kids who are disrespectful and never come to class on time. He also tells it how it is. When I had him for art exploration A, he gave me great constructive criticism on my pretty bad work, but he and I would just look at it and laugh and everything about that, but he helped me improve my rough copy, which and always will be the best painting of my life. Mr. Randolph pushes students to achieve their full potential. He is by far one of the most caring, patient, understanding people I will ever meet. I am so grateful to have had him for my for art 3 years in a row. Thank you for so much, everyone.
Tonight, I'm going to be honoring Ms. Lesiak. When I started high school, I was struggling with severe anxiety, and I didn't think I'd be able to find a place in the school that would make me feel happy or comfortable. But in the summer of 2013, before my freshman year, I went to my first drama society meeting, making myself give it a try. As soon as I walked into the room, I was welcomed by Ms. Lesiak, and as a director, she gave me the most courage I've ever had in my life. She's helped me get on stage and helped mold me into the person I am today. Even after she was no longer the director of Drama Society, I could always go to her room and talk to her if I was having a bad day, and she would make me feel so much better. At times, I knew she was one of the only people I could go to. As the SATs rolled around and I was a form of a ball of tangled up stress, I walked in her office and I immediately felt better because I knew she would have advice for me that would get me through the rest of the week. Without her in my life, I don't know who I would be today or how I would be as comfortable as I am today on stage. I definitely don't know how I would have survived high school. So thank you, Ms. O, for everything you've done for me.
Okay. I'd like to honor Mr. Behrens tonight. I want to honor him because during my freshman year, he was my science teacher. At the time, I was new to Roseville Community Schools. Being in his class made me appreciate the change, though. While being placed into an oversized science class, learning was difficult due to the size of the class. When this class was filled up, Behrens made learning easier for me and other kids as well. He's a great teacher who's always in a positive mood and making sure his students felt comfortable. He also always had a positive attitude as well. After my freshman year, I had no other classes with Mr. Behrens, but throughout my high school career, anytime I've ever seen him in the hallway, he always went out the way to ask me how I was doing, how my day was going, or just a simple hello during passing time. Something so simple goes a long way, and that's why I'm honoring Mr. Behrens.
Tonight, I am honoring Mr. Eric Madison. Being a Roseville student for the past 13 years, I've been very fortunate to have had many great teachers, and Mr. Madison is no exception. I chose to honor him tonight because of the impact he's had on me by not only being a great teacher, but also being someone I know I can go to. Mr. Madison has always pushed me to be the best I can be and nothing less. He always gives his honest opinion and would never judge the decisions I make. Madison, you have been the most inspiring person I've had the privilege to work with these past 4 years of my high school career. Every day I feel like I learn something new about you that makes me admire you more. To think that something as simple as me switching out of news and broadcasting one could have been the difference between who I am today and who I could have been is crazy. Without your constant efforts to get me outside of my comfort zone and keep me on track, I'd still be the shy sophomore who sits in the back of the room and didn't try all that hard to get her work done. Between my procrastination and stressing out over literally everything, I'm sure I make you want to pull your hair out sometimes, but I appreciate you sticking by me through all of it and not losing faith in me. No matter what I'm going through, you always seem to have the right things to say. Not being able to come to your room to just talk is going to be hard while I'm at college, but we both know I'll be back. I thank you again for helping me become who I am today, and I know that whatever challenges I face in life, I'll always ask myself, what would Madison say?
Tonight, I'm honoring Brad, my soccer coach, and he's the first person that came to my mind when we had to pick. Ever since day one, he has seen potential in me that no one else has. He believed in me, and even though I thought I was good, he pushed me to do better. He's been my coach for all 4 years of my high school career and is one of the most important people in my life. Through those 4 years, he's seen me grow as a soccer player and encouraged me to do better. When he came to the program, he did great things when he became a varsity coach. The record switched and losses became wins. He got the boys a winning record and district game win, and he also got the girls 2 winning records and 2 second place tournament trophies for the first time in a long time. On the bus ride back from that second tournament, we had lost to Richmond and ended up taking second place, and he talked to each of us individually to keep our heads up, and he saved me for last. When he finally got to me, I said get away because I knew I was gonna cry. He told me I was the heart of the team and that he was proud of me, that I'm a true leader, and I immediately started crying. But this soccer program isn't just a boys and a girls team, but we're all a family. And he only doesn't care about us just as soccer players, but us as individuals as well. Thank you, Brad, for being the best coach I've ever had.
Tonight, I'm honoring my art teacher, Ms. Rawson.
Throughout the 14 years in which a student attends school, they are introduced to various classrooms, each presenting a different teacher in an unfamiliar environment. For that one class in which a student cannot wait to attend, there is another in which a student may question whether or not a couple absences will hurt anyone. As for Ms. Rawson's classroom, there hasn't been a day where I did not want to be present. You would think that after having Ms. Rawson not only once or twice, but five times and still counting, I would be skipping her class whenever the opportunity presented itself, especially after coming to know her weird but humorous outbursts. But her classroom has truly become a safe haven, and Ms. Rawson has grown to be more than just another teacher. Her class is a place where I'm pushed to be the best version of myself, not only through my artwork, but also through who I am as a person. She is the one teacher I can go to for almost anything, knowing she will be there to the best of her ability. Going beyond the basic principles of art, I have learned an abundance of things while being Ms. Rawson's student, such as always having room for improvement, taking other people's criticism, and inviting change for the better. I will honestly admit that there are times I am hesitant about turning in my artwork because I know 9 times out of 10 I will be sitting right back down with the suggestions of such as shading darker, outlining thicker. Though this is almost always predictable, I know after reworking, those little suggestions will change the whole outlook on the piece. Of everything I can honor Ms. Rawson for, there is one attribute of hers that stands out the most. Out of all the amazing teachers I have come to know, I can honestly say I've never felt more accepted and important as a student than from her. She teaches her students to confidently express who they truly are. Walking into her classroom daily, I'm confident that I can express who I am and how I'm feeling without being reprimanded or judged for it. Being different is thought of as a privilege, a way to stand out from all the rest, and that is what Ms. Rawson strongly encourages. She teaches that being who you are has no limits. For example, along with being who I am comes my famous blonde moments that can probably get annoying at times, but somehow she deals with them in a positive aspect. So when I ask the question, what teacher has impacted me the most in my life, there is no doubt in my mind that I would pick Ms. Rawson, a teacher who inspires me to be the best version of myself, puts a smile on my face even through the bad days, and changes every so-called flaw I have into a strength.
Okay, so spending a long time in Roseville, you get to know a lot of teachers well. Some you get to know more. And then for some of us today, it was easy to just pick out one. Why am I crying? This is lame. Okay.
This is lame.
So weird. It took a lot of thought to pick one. I chose a former teacher and a coach who stood out to me, but may not have been recognized by others. Mr. Borsey was introduced to me as a coach in the seventh grade. Coming to tryouts, I had no clue what to expect. It was scary. Within minutes of being at tryouts, I knew that I wanted him to be my coach. The energy and passion he had to teach clueless girls how to play a sport he loved was so unique that first season of my ongoing basketball career not only made me a good player, but also made me love the sport. Thanks to my first coach, Mr. Worsey, his energy was never absent in the classroom either. From the creativity he was able to add to novels that we had to read in English Literature Arts, to a scripted lip sync performance in drama, he never failed to keep me interested to come back to his classroom the next day. Any teacher can teach, but it does take something extra in order to make them want to learn. Thank you, Borsey.
Tonight, I am choosing to honor my teacher, Ms. Jordan. As a sophomore walking into AP composition, I had no idea what exactly to expect. However, after being introduced to so many new topic discussions, ways of learning, and moreover ways of life, I realized this was somebody I looked up to. I've learned so much more in AP composition and AP literature than I have in any of my other classes. Ms. Jordan is the type of teacher that wants you to learn and store your knowledge, not just memorize information for a test and then throw it away. I respect this view, as it has made me a better all-around student. Walking into Ms. Jordan's class every day was always what I looked forward to. I knew we were going to be doing some sort of creative project or having one of our famous open discussions. Ms. Jordan is one of the most intelligent people I will probably ever meet. She is successful and somebody I aspire to be. She is the definition of a mentor for me. She has gotten me ready for college, making me feel so much more confident about the whole idea of going away. And furthermore, she has prepared me for life. I know even after high school, Ms. Jordan's guidance will always be with me, and she is definitely somebody who has impacted my high school experience in a plethora of ways. I just wanted to say thank you, Ms. Jordan, for being not only my teacher and instructing me, but developing me into the student and the individual that I am today.
Tonight I am honoring a person who, in my opinion,
thank you.
Should be honored in everywhere possible. In sixth grade, I never thought she would have such a large impact on me, Miss Eschenberg. When sixth grade began, she was tough. She understood what we were capable of and wanted us to do just that. But she was more than just a teacher to me. I often found her wiping my tears and making my smile stretch from ear to ear. I can't even begin to tell you what I would tell her. Ms. Eschenberg is the kindest soul. She still inspires me to be as humble and as courageous as she has been and always will be. In sixth grade camp, we did a little zip line, not too big, but enough to scare me. And if it wasn't for her, I probably wouldn't have such a great story to tell about ziplining. Over my years in middle school and high school, I've realized that happiness is not a destination, but a mood. I can't thank Ms. Eschenberg enough for always putting me in that mood, whether it was back in sixth grade or the days I spent with her after I picked up my brother. Thank you for molding me into the person I am today, and you mean the world to me.
All right, so I've been stood up today. But I'm honoring Mr. LaMontagne. When asked to pick a teacher to honor here tonight, Mr. LaMontagne was first to come to mind. When I first walked through this class, seventh grade year, I knew I was going to have the best time. I remember from day one, my best friend and I, Brittany, would talk British to him so he would think that we were foreign exchange students. He would always just go along with it, even though we annoyed him so much. He never failed to put a smile on my face, and overall, I just wanted to thank Mr. LaMontagne for being an unforgettable teacher. Some of my favorite middle school memories came from you and your class, and it was an honor to have you as a teacher for 2 years.
I chose to honor my former TC, Ms. Deliberti. When I first made the transition from Lincoln to Fountain after third grade, it was an extremely difficult transition. I didn't know what to expect. You were able to help me through the transition. Whether I was going to you for extra help on an assignment or going to you for something that was wrong, you were able to help me get through the situation at hand. You motivated me to do more for school, most importantly getting the NHS, the best decision I made in high school. Above all, you were always one of the most caring people towards me. Hopefully, after the senior year comes to a close, you would still be someone I can go to as an additional aid. I will truly miss being one of the students.
Today I'm honoring my French teacher, Madame Bourgeois. When you start high school, you never know how your first day is going to go. You're walking around a school with hundreds of people you've never met before and teachers that could be more than intimidating. And then I remember walking into my fifth hour French 3 class. I remember we started off doing a ridiculous icebreaker that is one of the ones where you're like, oh, do you have a cat? You know, I'll write your name down on that slot type of thing. I just remember Madame walking around the entire time, making sure we were doing it correctly, not cheating, you know, speaking en français. And I knew that it was going to be one of my favorite classes. I had it again for, you know, 3 years, up until junior year. And Madame was just one of the best teachers that I've ever had. And I always can, you know, I always knew I could go there and talk. And I knew that if I can make it to that hour, you know, the day was done. And it was, you know, going to be fine for the rest of the day. Through all 3 years that I was in Madame's class, we did countless videos and skits that really helped me with being a more social person and being more out there. And I know that I'm not the only person that has benefited from Madame, and I know I'm not the only one in the room has benefited from her, and I know that I won't be the last one that will.
I would like to honor my project challenge teacher from 4th to 6th grade, Mrs. Gitter. She is really what started my drive and motivation to work harder and aim higher. I never realized the magnitude of the impact she had on my life until recently. She was able to push me further than any teacher had ever had before. I was always so lazy in school, and she forced us to work harder and really go above and beyond. Mrs. Gitter was able to make learning fun and interesting. I never used to think reading was fun until she had us read books and then play a trivia game on the books afterwards. I always wanted to win. She never treated us as kids, but as adults, and it was very refreshing to finally have a teacher see me as a mature student. Project Challenge taught me how to do the basics, but it was so much more. We immersed ourselves in foreign country and culture, and I had never researched before, and she taught me the foundation of almost all the skills I would need for future assignments. She was also able to teach us so much in the short amount of time we had with her. It was honestly the most powerful and important time of my life. Without Mrs. Gitter, I don't believe I would be up here tonight. I don't think I would ever have found my motivation for school without her. She taught me that I could be so much more and that I could be successful. She taught me to think outside the box and to challenge myself. After having Mrs. Gitter as a teacher, I tried to really challenge myself in everything I did because I understood I would only get better if I challenged myself. She not only shaped me into the student I am today, but she has shaped me into the person I am today. I truly thank you, Mrs. Gitter, for helping me see my true potential.
Today I'm honoring my freshman basketball coach, Coach Smith. And if you knew Coach Smith, it would be pretty self-explanatory as to why I chose to honor him. And I can still remember being a freshman, it's my first year of basketball ever. And you know you messed up on the court because Coach Smith's eyes will get really big. And you can just, and you can just feel the heat on your back. And then he would sit you down. He would pull you out, sit you down. And he wouldn't just be like a coach that wouldn't say anything to you. He would sit you down. He'd be like, son, did you lose a girlfriend or something? And he would talk with you and he would try to fix the problem and put you back in. You know, coming out as a freshman, first year of high school basketball, Coach Smith was really like a second dad. He was the first coach to ever push me to be my best, and I truly believe it was because he cared about our development, not only as basketball players, but as men, as young men. Our season wasn't as successful as it could have been, but at the same time, Coach also had like about 14 hot heads to take as a second kid, so it wasn't the easiest job, as you could imagine. I've never had a coach that was so involved and cared so much about the whole program. He was always trying to learn just as much as us, always watching the varsity and the varsity head coach, Coach Hanson, trying to better himself as a coach. He was really a great role model for me and re-implemented a lot of the lessons that my dad taught me, because you know, sometimes I go to practice and I'd be like, I could have sworn I heard this at home. And Coach, you know, you are appreciated, and thank you for all the tough love, man.
Last but not least, I am honoring my history teacher, Mr. Blackmer. When I received my second trimester schedule during freshman year, and so I had Mr. Blackmer for world history, I did not really think much of it. Little did I know that that class would change my life. Mr. Blackmer's perspective of teaching was one of the best and most successful I have ever seen in my whole schooling career. His goal was to make sure that every student was going to pass, was going to learn, and was going to walk out on the final day of class with a new perspective of life. Mr. Blackmer did just that, for every class and every student he taught. For every set of notes, and there were a lot of them, for every quiz or test, and for every project, no matter the assignment he had the students complete that day, I always walked out of his class saying to myself, I learned something new today. The calm atmosphere in the classroom and the jokes we always made while learning and just all around having fun in the class are some of the best memories in high school for me. However, Mr. Blackmer is not only a great history teacher, he's also a great guy to just sit down, talk to, and have fun with. Every morning during my sophomore year, my upperclassmen friends and I would go into Mr. Blackmer's room, chill out before the day, and play paper basketball at the trash can. And I'm not going to lie, I was kind of bad at it. And on days where my friends weren't in there in the morning, we would just sit there and talk about our days. Whenever I needed advice about something, help with assignments, or just sit down and talk to about what was going on in our lives, Mr. Blackmer was always a chilled out guy who will listen, help you out, and wish you the best. Throughout all the jokes we've made, all the nicknames you gave my friends and I, all the crazy trick shots, and all the missed shots in paper basketball, I am very appreciative for Mr. Blackmer has taught me. So thank you, Mr. Blackmer, for not only being a great teacher, but being a great guy.
No one sat down yet. A lot of tears for a happy occasion. On behalf of the Roseville schools, I am so proud of you students. I'm so pleased and happy with the quality of education that you receive from the teachers here tonight. The four principals, I believe, from the high school are here tonight, and we need to recognize them for their leadership and their responsibilities in putting this all together also. I know I saw Mr. Crow, Mr. Borzy, Mr. Adams, and Miss Gabriel. Can you guys wait? Look at this picture!
Mr. Chef.
I tripped over him coming up here. As important as the teachers are, there's somebody that's more important to these young men and women in their lives, and it's you as parents and guardians and relatives. Can we start? And can you recognize who's here with you tonight?
My mom is here, and so is my grandma right there. Okay.
My dad in the bright yellow hoodie, and then my boyfriend in the red one.
My mom is here with me today.
My whole family's sick, so like I'm the only one here right now.
Oh, Alex, we're here for you, bro.
I'm here with my mom and my friend Alex Gonzalez.
I have Mr. Reinowski.
We're here for you, Samantha.
I'm here today with my mom and dad. I'm just kidding. I'm here today with my mom and dad, but I also want to recognize my sister and my future brother-in-law who couldn't make it today.
Oh. I'm here with my dad in the back there.
I'm here with my mom and my sister.
I'm here with my mom today.
I'm here with my mom and dad.
I'm here with my beautiful mother in the blue and my cousin that's right by.
I'm here with my mom and dad, my best friends right there, the gray north faces, my homies.
I'm here with my mom, my dad, and my sister.
My mom and my little sister and my niece Melanie came to support me tonight. Thank you.
I'm here with my mom and my brother.
I'm here with my mom and my aunt.
I'm here with my mom, dad, and boyfriend.
I'm here with my friend Raven. My mom is not here tonight.
We also have a lot of administrators that are here tonight, some here from central office, some from the buildings. Can I ask all of them to please stand and let us recognize you? Kelly Jo. Roseville Schools and Roseville City are blessed with the relationship that we have between the two of us. There is not an event or something that takes place in the city that we don't support. There's nothing that we do in the schools that the city does not support. We have two city council members here with us tonight that have come on their own time. Mr. Watisha, Mr. Frontera, can I ask you to wave also? During the day, we were extremely lucky to even have more officials come to work with the students, be with the students, take part in part of the day with the students. We had Senator Beta that was here today. We had Representative Churkin. We had Kathy Haw, Councilwoman. We had Mayor Robert Taylor with us today. And we had Councilman Mr. Bill Shoemaker with us today. Am I missing anyone? I think all of them were here today. We'd like for the teachers to sit down, and those of us that were your counterparts today, if we could walk and come behind you, and maybe somebody from one of our group wants to say something too. So if the staff could please sit down. This is being filmed right now. It is going to be on cable within about a week. And we are also making a copy to give to the students right now, or so they'll have a copy automatically. The fun part is, as I told them earlier today, about 10, 15, 20 years from now, when they have their own kids or their own grandkids, they can pull out the video and show their kids what took place.
I really had to cut it short. I was cut it short. I was like,
we just have a little bit more business to attend to before the kids adjourn this meeting. I sat down there and I thought, look at all these women up here on the board as officers and board members. I thought, wow, what a difference compared to all the men that we at Booth and I have to deal with every year. And Scott. So it was a nice change. Sorry. I said Ruthie. Also, I sat back and I thought, I don't remember ever talking about my nuns. I couldn't even talk about my nuns when I had them in high school, like you kids talk about your teachers. And you know, you just have a nice friendship with them, and they were your friends for a long time, and you remember them, and it was very nice for all of us. It brings, chokes us all up. So you guys did a super job. Your questions that were flashed at you, you did a good job. And how it runs down, you know how to do that. That was good. So we're going to go around, and if you guys want to say anything after Mr. Clement, we'll let you say anything else you'd like to say.
Just a parting shot for me before I shut up. Before you leave, take a look at the artwork that's on the back wall. Two art teachers were recognized tonight. And
she's up there a couple times.
And you can see the quality of the work that's up there. And once again, it makes us real proud.
Madam President, I have a question.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he does that all the time. We had to put that in there. Thank you, Joe. That was good. Who wants to start? You on there in the end? Would you like to start?
Yeah, I'll start.
Okay.
I just want to say that I enjoyed this opportunity, and I'm glad that I got to recognize Mr. Behrens today and have a chance to talk with Ms. Diane Kott.
I also had a nice time today. It was really nice to be able to get to speak with the higher-ups and understand all the things that go on in the background, and I enjoyed being able to recognize Mr. Madison.
I'm pretty sure we're going to say the first same thing. So, yeah, we all had a good time. And Matt McCartney couldn't make it, and I've only talked to him once, but he seemed like a pretty good guy. And I did have a good time, like, talking to Ms. Teresa, and I like the lunch and everything was really nice.
I've looked forward to this since freshman year, and I had a lot of fun and a good time, and I've learned a lot about the school board, and thank you.
Just want to let you know, the Outback was really great. And I also enjoyed the snacks here. And Mr. Clement is a swell guy. And thanks for giving us the opportunity to be here today.
Let me just put a plug in for Outback. Raven mentioned Outback. We took the students there today, and we had every anticipation that it was going to be an expense that we were going to have to pay the bill. They completely picked up the bill at Outback for all the students and all the guests that were there. So that's a plug
for food is good food.
Okay.
This was something I've always looked forward to since freshman year too, so it was a really good experience, and I like getting to know all of the board members, especially Miss Teresa. They're all really cool, and I love doing it. So,
I had a really good time honoring Miss Eschenberg. She's one of a kind. Thank you for letting me go with you, since I obviously didn't have anybody today. And the Outback was great. The baked potato was great. and thank you for the opportunity.
The food was good. I enjoyed honoring Mr. Lamonte, even though he couldn't make it. It was an honor to get to talk to Miss Ruth Green. And overall, it was fun. Yup.
I felt like the day was great. I was really glad that we got to talk to someone that would we can talk to the problems around the school about, and that we can actually find someone that may solve these problems. So the day was pretty great. I'm glad I got to get this experience.
All right, so I want to thank everybody for putting this on for us. It's probably not an easy thing to do. I'm thankful that we got the day off of school. I'm also glad I know who did, chooses snow days. Now. So I'll remember. All right. And I want to thank everybody for coming.
I had a good experience today, and I had a good time speaking with Mr. Headmark about college.
I'm really thankful for the experience, and thankful for the insight that Mr. Denning here offered me in terms of being a lawyer. Outback was pretty good. I had a well-done burger.
Yeah, so basically everything they said. It was an honor to honor Mr. Blackmer today. And as I was noticing through today, it seems like Mr. Steeland is a guy that always gets picked on around here.
Give him the $20. Give him the $20.
Because as we had our tour today, they always knocked on his horrible jokes, but I thought they were pretty funny. But it was great because he gave me some good advice today about what to do after high school, so I am thankful for that, and it was a pretty good day.
Well, now you know how much that $20 meant. It was a really great honor for me to be able to honor Mr. Reinowski today, because he definitely deserves it, and I'm number one. And I also had fun with Mr. Janae today. I got to take pictures of all your kids and their counterparts. So that was fun, and also the food was great. All in all, today was a good day.
It was a pretty swell day.
Pretty swell.
Outback was pretty good. I really liked honoring Mr. King. I feel like he's really underappreciated in our school.
I enjoyed today. It was very, very opening, mainly because I talked to Mr. Rice, and we talked about college and just the future, and I really liked honoring Mr. Moore.
I'm very thankful for this opportunity, especially to honor my coach, and I'm very thankful that I got to reconnect with Ms. Tamala and talk about the thing that I'm thinking of going into, and it was great to see the other side of the school board, what goes on.
I got to check out the tech room with Mr. Michael Antoine, and we talked about baseball, which was really cool. And
it was great. I appreciate the free food. Mr. Smith's a great guy. He let me feed the fish in the koi pond and in the aquarium, and I also talked on dispatch to the bus driver, so it was fantastic. It was a great day, and I'm really thankful for just this whole day.
President has one order of business. Mr. Command wants to say
I was just going
to
say, on the wall to your left is the pictures of the past school boards. A group picture has been taken, and within a couple weeks, we will have all these students' pictures up there that will go down in history and will be there forever. So.
Mr. Command's done, so you can finish off the meeting.
I need a motion to adjourn.
Motion by Safash Kulkani.
Seconded by Schmidt.
All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed?
Nay.
Motion carries.
He doesn't get it wrong.